New York. New York. New York is about people living next to each other. And if you play an instrument, a musical instrument, you're going to have to be open to the fact that your neighbors might have to go to work while you want to practice your instrument. And that's always been a big, big problem for me. Anyway, so I was living down on Grand Street, down on the Lower East Side, by the way. And the same situation was obtained. You know, people in the apartment above me. I had a problem because, as I said, I'm a very sensitive person. I don't like to cause any sort of discomfort. And of course, that basically was the problem. So I happened to be walking one day down on Delancey Street. And anyway, I was walking and I was sort of walking by the bridge that goes over to Brooklyn, you know, the Williamsburg Bridge. And I saw these steps leading up to the bridge. And you know, I hadn't really thought about it before. I walked over and I walked up the steps. And there, in front of me, was an expanse of bridge. Nobody up there in the middle of the day. So I said, okay. And I walked across the bridge. I walked across the bridge. Nobody walking in any direction. There were trains coming across the bridge. Automobile traffic. And below was the river. And there were boats coming up and down the East River. And it occurred to me that this would be a perfect place to bring my horn and practice in perfect peace. And so I wouldn't be disturbing anybody, and I could blow as long as I wanted, as hard as I wanted. I'd taken a sabbatical at the time. So I'd go up there every day and night, and nobody would bother you. New York City is a very cosmopolitan place. The people are very sophisticated. They walk by, they see some guy, they don't give a hoot. He's out there playing his saxophone. They don't care. They just walk by. So I'd be there. And I took some of my friends up there with me at different times. And it was just a gift from heaven. And I stayed up on that bridge until being discovered up there by a jazz writer who happened to live in Brooklyn and was walking across the bridge. And he knew that I was on sabbatical and that I had disappeared from the music scene. This was my intent until then. So he wrote this story, and the news got out, Sonny's on the bridge. And as it turned out, it was a very romantic story. The lone musician practicing on the bridge under the New York skyline. And the boats going below, and sometimes I'd blow my horn at the boats, and they'd answer back. It was really a magical experience. Eventually, though, I had to come back to work. But you know, I still went there to practice. You know, and I had a really high point in my life. I mean, I'm just eternally grateful for my whole career. I'm grateful that I'm paid to do what I love, to play my saxophone. I'm grateful that I'm able to make a living playing and make some art. And by the way, I had a nook in that bridge where I couldn't be seen by the trains or cars, and so if they heard me, they couldn't see me. So it was just a perfectly private spot. And that's a bridge story from Sonny Rollins. Thank you, thank you. Cheryl Pyle. Cheryl Pyle includes. Bass Bridge Quartet.